In today's video, we're going to talk about Sky Domes in Twinmotion 2022 preview. My name is Katarina, I'm a garden designer, and I see you next. Welcome to another video from Garden Design Tools, and today's video is all dedicated to Sky Domes, one of the latest updates from the Twinmotion 2022 preview that's live in their website. So the link will be in the description of this video if you wanted to try it on, if you want to download it and try it on. So what I'm using is Twinmotion Trial 2022.1, okay? So you have it here on top, and we're going to talk about Sky Domes. So what is Sky Dome? Like the name says, it's a dome that you can apply to your model that's the sky. So it's a high quality HDR sky image that you can apply to your model. So if you remember, if you worked before in Twinmotion, what you had in terms of sky was very limited, okay? So if you like me, that you like always a little bit of clouds in your renderings to give it a bit of texture, to don't appear such a boring sky, what you had is in weather, you could come around and play a little bit with the clouds. If you didn't want it rain, you play a little bit with the seasons. Sometimes you change a little bit, but mainly you play here with the clouds a little bit, and you could do something in the sky to give it a bit more texture, to make it a little bit better in terms of renderings. But now you have an amazing thing that's called Sky Dome. So Sky Dome is in your library, as you can see here. Like you have materials, the Quixel Megascan here, textures and the 3D assets. Now you have here Sky Domes, okay? So you have morning and afternoon, clear Sky Domes, okay? And you have all these ones, it tells you here in the preview. And how this works, it's really clever in Twinmotion. Like the Quixel Megascan library, you don't actually have them already with you. This is like links that you download the ones that you're interested on, okay? So as you can see here, I already downloaded this one. You can after give it a little heart so it's in your favorites. It's easier to just quickly apply to your favorite ones. You have cloudy ones. Some of my favorite are always with a bit of cloud, okay? And you have quite a lot of really nice skies to apply, and you have the overcast, and this is the morning and afternoon afternoon settings, okay? So it's just downloading, so that's why it's taking a little bit longer, okay? And this is the overcast. So you have the noon, let's make it a clear sky. Have a cloudy sky, okay, this looks good. I'm gonna put this one to download already so I can come here and see it up. And of course the overcast and noon. And after you have low sun, so this can be early morning or late afternoon. And again, beautiful skies. So if you hover with the mouse, you always have the preview there, as you can see, and the different materials as well, how they reflect. So really, really cool settings. I really like, this is taking a little bit because it's downloading. This is, for me, is one of the best things in terms of updates in Lumion, because I think it's really a good sky for your renderings. It's gonna make a huge difference. But because this is not just about sky, this is gonna influence all the lighting in your materials, in your reflections, etc. So let's go into that one that I've downloaded. That's this one. And let's apply, okay? So you just apply, and like if you remember Quixel Megascans asset, they create the object the first time around, okay? The second time you're gonna use it's not gonna be like this, but the first time around, that's how it does. It actually creates an object, okay? So as you can see, look at this, it's amazing. So it's a huge difference of what you had. Let's go a little bit further out. So it's a huge difference in terms of sky of what you had previously in Twinmotion, okay? And this is really gonna influence how you see your garden. in terms of reflection of quality of light, much more realistic. So let's go and check out the Sky Dome settings. So you go in here in the settings tab, and you go into lighting. Sky Dome is on, so you can just quickly see the difference between on and off, and you go to more. Okay, so in more you can play around with the intensity of the Sky Dome. Okay, I'm gonna leave more or less as a default like it was. If you go here to more, you can change the ambient, you know, play around a little bit how the Sky Dome influence all your project, all your garden in this case. So you can match the sun on or off, you know, you can choose to rotate. So in here you have to think a little bit how is north in the when it's, because this was a noon sun position, it's not going to be a big problem because probably the sun, it's at 12 o'clock, so it's up and high in the sky. But you can rotate here a little bit and play around with the shadows in your garden. So, and you have here on or off the Sky Dome, how it affects the lighting in your project. Okay, on or off. Okay, so you can see here it's a big difference. And smog, if you want on or off, in this case it doesn't matter. But don't forget, in settings, in lighting, that's where you're going to find out all the Sky Dome settings you can play around with. Okay, so if you want to refresh, if you want to open, if you want to clear, if you want to go to the library to check out a new one, you can do all that from here. So what I'm going to do now is actually do a couple of renderings so you can check it out, the difference between with Sky Dome, without, and with Path Tracer. Path Tracer is one new thing as well inside Twinmotion, but that's another video we're going to talk about, okay? So see you guys in a bit after I've done the renderings. So let's check out these images. This one is without any Sky Dome, the normal Twinmotion sky. The only thing I have here is I have the filter of the light line. It's the only thing I have added here. The second image is already using the sky. So you have already a much better quality of light in your materials, in your water a little bit as well. But in the whole ambience, you have a much better quality of light already. And, you know, you have this nice soft clouds. Of course, you know, you can play around with the sky and do a bit more textured, a bit more interest there in the sky in terms of cloud, but you can already see a big improvement. Of course, you still had, I don't have any reflection probes here, so you don't have this window working really well. But I just wanted to show you a little bit the third image, that's with using the Sky Dome plus the Path Tracer, the next video we're going to talk about. So amazing shadows and reflections. Okay, this is in the high setting, so it takes much longer to render the image. Okay, have that in consideration when you're thinking about this, but you have a much better quality of light. The only thing I just want to tell you is in the Path Tracer, and we're gonna talk this in a video after, I take the emissiveness of materials off. I toggle them off instead of on, because it's too much. They trace the light too much in the materials where I'm using here for this light fixture. But the glass reflection, it's amazing. Okay, so that's very exciting news for Twinmotion users. We're gonna do a new one, a new video very soon about new plants from Quixel Megascan inside Twinmotion as well. Nothing really, really amazing in terms of planting inside Twinmotion, but you know, you have a few new vegetation so we can play around with. I hope you enjoyed. I'm gonna add these images in the end of this video. Don't forget, you can always go to the public roadmap and check out what's in progress, under consideration, and what's already released. Under consideration, there is really exciting things. Especially, I wanted for you to check it out, the changing materials in presenter mode. So if you know about presenter mode in Twinmotion, it's a really cool way for you to share your project with your client. And imagine that they can very soon maybe change the pavement, change the decking, the type of decking, whatever, you know, change materials inside. So that I found that really, really cool. And they have really exciting things under consideration and in progress as well. Okay. In terms, I haven't seen nothing really in terms of new planting under consideration, but you know, still exciting things to come. See you guys in the next video. Bye bye.